Well, g'day tubes, how's she hanging? What a slop med pit out here I got now. But I have smoothed her out a bit. Got rid of all the big ruts anyways. That little box blade the other day worked pretty good before we got all the rain. Now it'd be just a freaking soup pile again. But anyways, no gravel showed up yet. So I don't know what's going on there. I can't exactly remember now how I left when I wanted it with them. I think I might have said, well, whenever you got a minute, bring it out, you know, because I can't really spread it out yet anyways. That's probably the way it turned out, but I can't remember. So one of these days we should have a couple of piles of gravel show up. He said he would call me first, and I haven't got a call, so. But as you can see, raining out here today. It was raining out yesterday. Let's have a look at the ice. Ugh. I don't know whether I want to walk on it now, but it's probably still okay. Yeah, she's a little thinner. Oops, let me go down the street. A little thinner than she was. It's probably still about 5 inches thick there, though. Ish, sort of, kind of. I don't know if I really want to walk on it or not, because it actually has, looks like it's kind of sagged in the middle. Usually that's what happens. It'll break through that middle, and then, it'll break through the middle and then kind of just go and then melter. Woo! Don't break through on me. Okay, we made her. The other side here is all broken through though. And well, till here. She's opened up again, so that's pretty good. But, anyways, the other day, well, about a week and a half ago, I ordered a new mattress online. Go figure, eh? Even the online sales are putting out the stores for mattress sales even. And I got one of those, they call a Casper mattress, and it's one of the memory foam ones. Comes from New York-ish area, New York. Ooh, branches. Ooh, drippies. Comes from New York, and free shipping. They'll send it to you. We've got a queen size bed, so we got a queen size mattress, and got her in the other day, and it comes in a box. I don't have the box here, but it's a box smaller than this propane tank, which is probably about 3 feet across. So I think this box might have been like 30 inch by 30 inch by actually it was probably about this tall, as wide as your mattress would be, kind of be, right? And it all comes bundled like this, what this thing looks like, in a big bundle. You pull it out of the box, and it comes with, I don't have it with me now, but it's a little box cutter guy. You know, it's got like the knife way inside, and it's got like a long hook, and you just hook the tie-back wrap that's around it, and you cut her down, and she goes and opens up really huge to your mattress, and then it's got like a plasticky cover on it too. You tear that off and you let her breathe for a day or so. It wasn't even that long. We slept on it that night. We opened it about 2 o'clock. Yeah, so we got that the other day. This is our last night, I guess, was the third night on it, and the first night was not good. Second night, yeah, it was pretty good. Last night was good until my wife started hacking, because she's got a bit of a cold happening now, and that was like 3 a.m. and I was up from then on, you know. So it's been one of them days. So the mattress we had before was a queen size beauty rest mattress. That's the one with the bowling ball, you know, the wine glasses on the thing, and then the bowling ball is jumping on the other side, or the guy's jumping on the other side, and the wine glass never moves. Well, I don't think that actually does work like that. Someone moves, you can feel it. But anyways, I'm like, oh man, I gotta get rid of my mattress now, and nobody's gonna want that, because it was, geez, it was 12, 13 years old, at least, something like that. So I'm like, okay, I could take it out to the transfer station, but being one of those beauty rest mattresses, I wanted to tear it apart, see what's in there. So I got all the crap off it, all the material, all the foam, all the crap. What else was there? Like a pillow top thing, which was all wore out from me. But for 12 years, 13 years, whatever it was, it's pretty good. You know, but it was getting to the point where I could sleep on it till about... Till about maybe 4 a.m. Oh, and then I'm tossing and turning, I'm sore, I'm like, okay, that's the end of this one. It was nice when we first got it, because it was like a nice, soft, and just kind of into the pillow stuff, right? It was beautiful, but it wore itself out, so the actual springy part, I think, is still fine. Like, they don't usually sort of wear out, but the comforting stuff, you know, like the pillow top and the cushy stuff is screwed, so we're like, okay, let's order this mattress. So we ordered it. It's like $1,000 for a queen size. They go right up to California King even, which is pretty huge. And I'm like, ah, queen, we'll stay with that, I guess. And yeah, so UPS brought her. It was claimed 68 pounds on the box, but I think it was more like maybe 100 pounds. It was a lot heavier than what the box said, so... yeah, so anyways, I got the thing all stripped off of here, right down to the springage. I'm gonna throw you on a tripod here, and apparently these are supposed to be an independent pocket coil mattress guy here. Let's just get the tripod out here first, and we'll have a look at it here. So, they are kind of independent, but they are joined together with this stuff here, you know? So it's like, sort of independent, but it's not really independent, but they're not actually like... I don't think they're actually like wired together like most mattresses are, and that's where you get, you know, this one moves and that one moves, where this, yeah, it's pretty good to a point, but then yeah, they all start to hook together and move. So we're gonna tear some of this off of here. I want to like look at one of the springs, and I'm gonna leave you guys just inside here a little bit under, well, I guess I got a little bit of eave here, so that's good. And we'll tear one of these off of here, because they're all kind of glued together in like a strip. Oh, geez, I gotta keep going. Oh, no, that one ended. I thought it was one whole Dewey. But basically just like, I don't know, all the foamy crap was like hot glued onto it. It's pretty springy still. Boing, boing. If I join them all together this way, got them all compressed down, and I stood on it and let her go, how many feet in air could I get? Wow. So this is actually, you know what? This stuff is exactly like what came on the new bed. It was squished down, I guess, with some kind of thing, and then they wrap this stuff around it and then let the squisher off, and away they go. So I think they call that like a Tyvek stuff. That's what they said on the box, was Tyvek stuff, so. Oh, geez. Oh, now I stretched her, trying to get her out. Got to unscrew it. There. Wow, not much really to it. That's all that holds you up all night. And you're moving, and it's... And all of a sudden one goes, boing, right up through your back. So, let's just yoink out the next guy here, too. If I can. This was like an $1,100 mattress, I think, too, when we got it. Maybe it was a little more, I can't remember. I wanted something good, because we had a... Before that, we had a bed that was just like a regular... One of these ones that are all hooked together, and oh, it was just a freaking nightmare. So, well, it's kind of good. They do kind of fold in the end of that spring, so you don't actually feel that pushing through. I know some cheap beds, all they would do is they'd still have them kind of bent up, sort of... Maybe not exactly that much, but to be bent up like that, and then you're laying on it, and then you can feel this piece always coming through on you, but these actually feel pretty good. Boing, 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 boing. Well, I don't know what I'm going to do here, because I don't really want to shred all these. I could scrap these things, I guess. Maybe we'll shred them. And after I get through one of these, I'll probably be like, yep, that's enough of that. Although this isn't really too bad for shredding. This is about the only metal piece in the bed that's, you know, salvageable. Yeah, this is going to take a long time. But honestly, I got nothing else going on today, so. We'll save springs out of a bed. And when we get them all done. I don't think I'm going to be able to count them because, well, I could count them now with just the way they're laying. Let's see how many is actually in this. I can't remember now. They had a count, two of them, you know. So let me give her a quick count here and we'll see what we got. Okay, there's our number. This is gonna suck. That's a lot of stripping, but it's not too bad, you know, it's not too bad on the hands. So we'll strip 660 of these. We'll put them all in a heapy pile down beside us here and show you that while we're done. I would film the whole thing, but I think that's gonna be excruciatingly boring for you. So we'll start stripping them and then show you the mess after. Okay, we're down to, I don't know, probably a little bit bigger, maybe, well, pretty much a single bed size. I don't know, I pulled off quite a few rows. There's some of the remnant dewies already. I figured I'd maybe do one row in high speed, just, you know, might look kind of funny or something. So, here we go. All right, we're down to six rows. The fingers are getting a little numb and kind of raw. But anyways, I think I should be able to get her finished. And we're getting quite a heap of crap there. But anyways, and there's our bundle of hair. It looks like hair when you get that much going there. So we got quite a few left to do yet. And probably going to break for some lunch and then we'll finish these up after. And see how much hair we got left. It's getting to be a pretty heavy pile too. I tried lifting some and it's like, holy, it's like a lot of weight, surprisingly. So it should be worth like, you know, $20 maybe at the most. But anyways, here we go. Well, we're down to our last row of ammo. Sweet. Thank frickin' goodness. Yep, ammo. So anyways, I figured I'd just... yak to you as while I'm doing this last one here. What was I going to yak to you about now? Can't remember now, isn't that awful? But anyways, I don't know if the camera's caught earlier there, but I got the our old half a Jeep yanked out here. I got a buddy that I played with some Minecraft with there a few years back now, and he's contacted me the other day and asked me if I was going to do anything with it. I'm like, I don't think so. It's pretty much wore right out that, well, not wore out, the body and back part of the frame just rotted right off it. So she's pretty much screwed for that unless you, you know, put a new, you know, the transmission and all that stuff, engine and stuff into a new tub and all that crap. But I'm like, I don't want to, I'd rather spend money on a new or brand new one and do something with it that way instead of, you know, messing with some old rotten out thing that needs all replaced anyways. So he's like, oh, I could use some parts off it. I'm like, you want to come up and get them, buddy? You come and get them. So Saturday he's going to come up. Been pretty anxious to actually meet him for quite a while. So it'll be pretty good. Have a little visit and stuff, and tear some Jeep parts apart. I'll show you that after, though. I was actually going to see if I could get it to start, but I cannot find where I put the key. The keys for it. So, yeah, I guess that's a no-go. I got like a secret sort of hidden drawer where I put all those kind of keys in, but it's not in there, so I don't know where the heck it went. Maybe we could jab a screwdriver in it. Turn it. Nah, I won't bother. It would probably, well, I don't know if it actually started on the run, but well, it's got no fuel tank. I'll show you in a minute here. If you've never seen any of the Jeep stuff, if you go way back in the channel, you'll see working on the Jeep. And I was going to do something with this guy, and then holy geez, it just ended up getting worse and worse and worse and worse and worse the more I got into it. And it got so bad, so far gone, so bad. You know, if I did get her kind of going, they never would have certified it. They would have looked at it and like, yeah, that frame's really bad. Somewhat like my other one. That's it. The downfall of the old Jeeps, they're just horribly rottened out. And I don't know if all, any of the new ones are any better, if they've changed their designs a little bit so they don't rot right out. But anyways. So, yeah, he's going to come up and get the parts out of it. And my buddy Matt as well is going to come up and see him. We used to all play together and stuff. Not everybody that we used to play with, but, you know, three of us that used to play together in the old good old Minecraft days when I had a big server going there. So, last two! Yay! So that should be good. And it'd just be nice to put the voice to a face, you know? So, and 660th! Oh, frig, my hands are just killing. But anyways, there we go. We are stripped down. And there's a pile of the pockets. And of course the thing of coils. That is a lot of freaking coils. Looks like a freaking bee's nest now. Holy crap. I gotta see if I can get under it and lift it. Or try to move it or something here. Let's see what happens. Heavy, you know that? That's pretty heavy. Should be fun trying to load them all. But anyways, we'll get them in, I'm sure, sometime here soon. I got some other crap I gotta scrap. And, you guys will be so sad with this. This isn't one of my things, but I got this, acquired this engine there, and it's junk, unfortunately, and it's like almost fairly brand newish. I'll look over here. It's an old Briggs & Stratton 18 horse. And the guy had it on like a lawn tractor, but he didn't, he hooked the throttle up or something, and basically it was able to go like completely wide open. And his grandkids or something were running on this tractor, first gear, just screaming it. It lasted about 3 minutes and it just completely exploded inside. There's, I don't even know if it's any of the bits are showing here. Anyways, one of the pistons is just, I think he's actually mostly put her back in inside so it's in contained, but it just completely obliterated everything inside it. So, junk. So he asked me if I wanted it for scrap. I'm like, sure, not much good for anything else. So, we got a little bit of a scrap pile started here. We'll have to take a run someday here and get rid of this crap again. Sure, I can dig up a little more. See, scrap prices. Really down right now, Iron Man was telling me. So he's like, oh man, there's no point in taking her now. You're only get like, you know, 5 or 6 cents a freaking pound. It's like, wow. Yeah, but the trouble is I can't really kind of just store it here. I got to get rid of it again. I can't just leave her hanging around, you know, or get people complaining to me about it. So I have to keep it moving. So, but for all it's really worth, just take it and get rid of it. So the, what was I going to say? My wife called, or contacted or something, somebody, about how much it is to get rid of a mattress. Yeah, it's only $6 to get rid of a mattress. So, oh well, that's all right. $6 I would have to pay to get rid of a mattress, but now I got this stuff all yanked out. I'm probably going to get, you know, $10 for the steel weight. So, I guess we made $4 today. Yay. Well, $10 really. It may be a little more than that, but not likely with the prices they are now. So, and that being kind of a spring steel, maybe if I claim it as being spring steel, it might get, you know, 20 cents maybe. I don't know. It's probably not much different. But anyways, let's clean up our little hoard mess here. And I don't know what else we're going to do today. Oh, we're going to look at the Jeep too. So we'll just have a little boo of that thing before we go today. Okay, so half a YJ, 1989 Jeep YJ this thing was. Pretty hard, pretty rough. And from here back was just rotten right out. Floor, everything was all rotten up here. The only part that was really any good was in and around the transmission and engine where it was splashing oil and crap up on it. And here's actually still a little bit of original paint on it. That's the shine's showing you that. A little bit of original paint. But down in here, it's all greasy and grimy from all the crap from years and years and years. And that's really about the only thing that was really any good on this whole entire thing. The whole friggin' tub just rotted out. Floor was just rotted. Started off with, had a hole in the floor. I'm like, oh, I could probably fix that. I started looking at it and digging at it, and it's like getting worse and worse and worse, and it's just all crumbly like that crap, right? So I'm like, holy. And you see here, it's just destroyed. So I kept cutting at her, and I thought, oh, this is just getting way too much. So then from here, the frame comes up over the axle and then down and then back up again. Well, this spot right in here, it just rotted right out, and it just destroyed the whole thing. Oh, my ratchet. I was looking for that. It's probably no good now. Oh man. Oh well, we'll leave them to rot with the rest of it. But funny enough, this thing, when I did have it running, when it did run, factory air conditioning still worked perfect. Couldn't believe it. But the only thing that's any good on this whole thing, oh, this is what he wants, is like the transfer case and stuff. The only thing that's any good on this thing is the stainless steel fuel lines. Holy cow. Couldn't believe it. They're still like nice, you know. But yeah, it's just hurting. And this thing too, I don't know. Like, I got my other Jeep there too, and it's 1 year newer. This thing has so incredibly many pressure lines, like vacuum lines, going everywhere, all these back here, where my other one has hardly any, and it's exactly the same engine. So I don't know why this one has so many going to everything, you know, all these things here, all this crap all down the side, and there's a huge thing down there they all hook onto, and holy crap, there's another big manifoldy guy here. And yeah, I don't know, the other one has hardly anything on it. It's just really weird, but I don't know, I don't get it. So probably if I shot a bit of gas down the carburetor, and if I could find the key, crank it over, it might take right off. I don't know. But I'm not going to worry too much about her. So after he gets his stuff stripped off her, which is, he wants the transfer case here. So this guy, so out of the transmission and then to your front wheel drive stuff. He wants that, and he wanted an axle off it. But I'm like, oh, I got these two axles I got from my other Jeep way back, which I don't think I'm going to use either, and they're just sitting here. So I'm like, you might as well take these guys here. So I'm gonna have to try to get these fellers out of here. And I got these used, I think, off of Kijiji. Looked it up, and yeah, they were available. Someone had some, so I went and picked them up. Got springs and shocks, probably are junk, but springs and everything on it still. So just pulled them right off, and I don't know what they did, but yeah, still got brakes on it even. Yep, brakes. So I'll have to try to get in here and get these fellers pulled out of here. Man, I'm telling you, having a set of forks on the front of this tractor has got to be the best thing ever. I'm telling you, it's super awesome. So I'm just actually, can't even see it here, but I'm actually hooked on that red tractor right now, which isn't mine either, but apparently it's not going to get fixed or whatever. So let's get rid of it here. There we go, our axles are out. Yeah, that didn't sound right. If you know what I mean. Yeah, so they're good. Hopefully he can use them. I don't know, they're not doing anything for me, just sitting here sinking deeper and deeper into the dirt, so he might as well take them and use them. They're probably going to need a little bit of work to get them moving again. I actually don't even know if they still do move or not. I'm sure they will. Maybe with a bit of persuasion. See, I've had them sitting here for a little while. I don't know how long where I got them from were sitting for. But they're probably going to need to have some work done to them, I would imagine. But they're not too far gone. Looks like someone's had her open though at one time. They've got some goo there, so it looks like they have been serviced. Now the only thing that's probably holding them is the brakes. Now this one, maybe the bearings on the outside too. Oh, that's moving there. Yeah, that's moving. The other side's moving. So something's not right there maybe, I don't know. And this one, the brakes will be holding these ones for sure, so the front axle. So, yes, lots of fun. Lots of fun. But, I don't know. I don't know what else to say. She's definitely rusty. Sometimes rusty is good. Oh, I just went and checked the mail. Look what I found. He found Princess Auto gear up for spring savings. So, whoa, almost missed my table. What have we got in the flyer this week? Nice camp chair and table. Don't think I need that. Plug your aerator. I always thought, you know, plugging this place might be good here, but the trouble is you'd be dinging these things off your cornerstones all the time, the little tine guys. So I'm like, yeah, wouldn't be too good. And then wrecking them probably, wrecking the tines and wrecking the stones, and can't do her, sorry. So, man, they're starting right off with trailer stuff today. Holy crap. Oh, what is that? 3,500 pound. Hang on, I gotta get you in there. 3,500 pound 12-volt A-frame trailer jack. $180. Woo, save $70 too. Wow, it's usually $249. Wow, I'll just crank it. Thank you. Some springs, some plugs, some trailer wire, more trailer stuff here, hitches, ball mounts, extender dewies, receiver adapters, ATV tires. Oh, yeah, I think I'm good. What else have they got? Oh, straps. Lots of straps, winches, hand winches, roller fair leads. What those are is your cable goes through that, so if you're pulling off the side, it kind of rolls on the little roller guys. This part here to here actually gets mounted on your thing, and then your cable comes through this way. So, pretty cool actually. Look at that, there's one right there. Showing ya. Yes, showing ya. So, more, man, lots of trailer stuff. Ramps. I don't need any ramps. I'm good. Although, Kermit the Frog might need some ramps. Kermit the Frog. Dog houses. Oh, I don't think I need one of them yet. Motorcycle cover. Got one. Solar panels. Got some. That's pretty cool, though. 12 outlet aluminum power bar. Just because 16, or no, 12 is not enough. Holy cow, that's a lot of juice. Gas pump handle dewies. Soft kennel. What is that? Diesel transfer pump. Oh, cool. Next. More lawn and garden stuff. Rollers, got one. Don't have one of these though, a drag harrow. I could make up too much mess out here. People get pretty upset. Pumps. Whoa, yeah, you're going to need pumps in this time of year. Ooh, wee. Oh, they even sell deep well pumps now. Wow, $429. Half a horsepower. 900 gallons per hour if your well will keep up to that. It's pretty good. They're like all stainless. That's why they're so expensive. built for long-term endurance. Yeah, I hope so. And more little pumps, little sump pumps. Ooh, hydraulic stuff, my favorite. Oh, sorry, looking at the bench instead. Hydraulic stuff. Now, look at these things here. These spool control thingies. So that's a stupid light. That's a pretty big one there. And five spools, $500. See, when I got prices from John Deere, each one of these little guys was separate. So you'd have your body part, and then you'd have your valve part inside with all the seals on it. They were all separate. Expensive. So even just a single spool, like this little guy here, for like a wood splitter, say, $109 for one. Wow, hydraulic stuff is always so expensive. Nice little power unit. There's reservoir. So what is that? 7 horse, 330,000 PSI, 2.5 gallon a minute, which isn't really that much. Well, what is that? Oil filter transfer cart. Oh, cool. Huh. Sure getting in a lot of cool stuff down here now.
Wish I had one closer.
Oh, there you go. You could pick your pocket with that little guy. I can't believe how much they actually charge for that. And it's a save $1,000. Normally it's $6,000 for that thing. And all it is an engine. Hydraulic thing, sort of like, well, be a little bit beefier than this guy. This guy here, sorry. Although it doesn't look much different. But anyway, so yeah, a little beefier. Digging strength is only 2,100 pounds. Maxing digging depth, 7.8 foot. Boom swing, blah, 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 blah. And you still gotta attach it to like a trailer guy. And these things just kind of go into the ground and that's it. And away you go. You know, if I really got ambitious, I could probably build one of these for maybe a couple of grand. The only thing that costs a lot is the freaking cylinders. And the hoses are a little expensive, but I mean, the rest of it's not really that bad, but oh man, it's pretty expensive though, eh? Wowee. And actually, I seen on their website when someone was using one of these, and I don't know if the guy didn't know what he was really doing running it, but it was a dog. Dog. Might be alright for digging like a little cremation hole for me or something here, but not for $6,000 or $5,000 there, save $1,000. That's just holy. That just seems like a lot. Demo models at select locations only. Oh, wow, I could, we'll try it. Oh, grenades. Nice. Flat screen TV. Some pressure washers up here. I think I'm pretty good for that. Oh, I'm really, really wanting to get one of those heated pressure washers like they sell there, which they don't usually have or have on sale because they're so expensive. But, you know, I'd only use it like once and then do what with it. So, yeah, just haven't bothered. You know, like for melting grease and stuff off of stuff, you could... I still want to build my own burner. I don't think it'd be that hard. I could even probably use my propane guy I got here with like a little hoodie thing on it with some piping going through it. Turn that on, heat up your pipes and your water, and you got a hot water pressure washer. So what do I got on this page? Battery charger, battery cables, some seat, weird looking seat thingies. One of those scanner tester OBD2 scanners. Work light. That's pretty cool. 65 liter portable oil drain. Wow.
What do you do with it though when you get it in there?
You still got a drainer out of that thing. Well, I don't see much more there. Ah, air power stuff, air tools and stuff. Auto body saw, nah. Air needle scaler, whoops, sorry, nah. Don't think I need one of those. Oh, there's a step drill set, that's kind of cool. I'm always wanting to get one of them. But, yeah. Now, there's what I should be getting for my blowing up my airlines. One of these guys here, what is it? Now, let's read it. Oh, it's not a very big air maker, though. It's only 11 CFM at 90 PSI, which I guess isn't too bad. I don't really like the Briggs & Stratton on it, though. But, I don't know, I was thinking of getting more one like of this style. A little bigger, a little better, you know, blah, blah, blah. You could do sandblasting with it if you wanted to. but I doubt they got anything else on that sale on the sale this week for those. Now they're done here already, and we're into just hand tools. It's nice chisels. Oh, tap and die sets. Pretty good for that too. Ooh,
a sprayer. Oh man, I left. Bleh.
Sorry, no air in here. I'm sleepy. Mask thing. Holy cow, respirator guy. Wowee, just read it. Read it. What else is on there? No measure tapes. Buffing wheel guys. That's kind of cool. I think I'd really have a use for that though. Cutting oil. Hey, I could use some of that sometimes when I'm drilling stuff. Oh, they got dry metal saw and like a skilly saw kind of guy now. That's cool. I got my big feller there on the floor that works really good. Power fist thingy guy, whatever it is. No, their other pro line, pro tool, something, whatever it's called. Pro point. And that, oh, that's cool. Metal bender. Pipe. And I guess that is about it today. Decoy cameras. Oh, that's no good. 1-inch gas water pump, 2520 gallon per hour. 98cc engine. That's kind of cool. Oh, that's cool. Steel hitch mount cargo carrier. Huh. That is pretty cool. It's pretty cheap too, but I bet you it's probably pretty cheap too. It's probably really chintzy thin metal, I bet. Probably goes and bends easy. Well, I guess that's it for that. I didn't really see anything I needed. How about you guys? So there's a shot of our nice finished maple syrup from the other day there. There's a little bit of settlement in the bottom, but I think that's the foam stuff. Kind of gets sort of in there, but it separates to the bottom, so you know you got lots on the top there anyway. So, but kind of hard to tell. You look at it like that, and oh god, it looks awful pale. It looks horrible, but I think it's the table coming through. Because if I go like this, it looks better. Or if I put, it's still crappy, but I think it's the table, because if you hold it up, it looks good. It looks fine, but down here, it's the table. That's why some of us maybe thought it looked kind of pale. But actually put these behind it now. Sort of, kind of. It is lighter, but I think it's that tree. That tree's always made like a really light syrup, but really super sugary. Super awesome, nice. And it looks to me like the lids have sealed down really well. So now if you open that, I'm not open, but I don't want to open it because then I'd have to eat it all. And I'd be like, yeah, the rest of the day. It would drive me nuts. So, but yeah, doesn't look too bad. I did try some of that. The other little bit didn't last very long. We had in the other jar. Oh man, holy cow, that stinks. Just brutal, brutally sweet stuff. And it's not too bad. It probably could have used maybe a hair a little more boiling, but it's not too bad. It's fairly syrupy. It's actually, it's deceiving because it looks really watery here, but you put a spoonful on your mouth, it's like eating honey. It's like really thick, gooey kind of stuff. So I just got the old computer here, which reminded me last night. My computer at the house has been driving me nuts for a while there. It's had a lot of, well, it's actually fine, but the video card was starting to, the fan was starting to make some pretty crappy noises all the time, and it would go away. Fine, but then if you shut the computer off, turn it back on, for like 2 days straight, it'd be just, so I'm like, holy crap, it was driving me crazy. So I ended up tearing it all apart last night, got the card out of the computer, should have videotaped it, but I thought, if I videotape it and I wreck this card, well, I'm not going to have a computer to render stuff anyway, so we didn't bother filming it. So it turned out pretty good, except when I was getting my little, okay, so you got to take, let me think now, there was four screws that, there's a shroud that goes over the fan and the cooling fin thingies that go back and forth, so it sucks the air in and then out the cooling fins. So that comes off, and then if you flip the card over, there was like a, a star thing with screws in each corner that screwed from the other side of the card into this unit where the fan is. And the star thing was metal, and then it had four screws, and then underneath the screws between the little metal thing and the board were these little spring guys. I'm like, holy crap, this is going to never go back together, right? So I got them all off careful and put them all down on the counter. It was good. And flipped it over, and I thought, okay, I'm going to have to get this fan right off the board, too. I'm like, oh, wait a minute, maybe I can just hold this and just pull the... No, I did have to take the actual fan assembly off. So there was another, okay, card, plate the fan mounts on, and then the fan mounts on this little plate. So I took all the plate and everything off after that shroud stuff, and basically unplugged the fan off the card. There's a little plug for the fan. And holding in my hand, pulled the fan off, and I just slipped a bit, and it grabbed one of the little fins on the fan and broke it off. I'm like, really? I'm like, wow. So anyways, I got under it with a little screwdriver and pried, and doink, off it come. And basically it's just on the other side of the fan that mounts down into the card, there's like a little pin that goes through a couple little bearings where there's some windings on the little motor, and on the inside of the fan there's the other part that, you know, the windings, magnetic dewy things that make the fan spin. So I'm like, okay. So I took that off. Got some, I think I just used some after run oil from my RC stuff. But one drop on the little bearing dewies, and give it all a good clean too, because there was dust under that thing that, you know, normally you can't get off. So I cleaned everything off all good, and cleaned all the little motor thing off all good with a nice soft brush, and just, you know, some air on it. And cleaned it all off, and then cleaned the inside of the fan and stuff. It was a bit crubby there too. And oiled it, put it back on. Got some crazy glue, stuck it on the one dab on the one side, and then stuck it to the back to the fan part, the little fin part. Hold her for like 3 minutes. Didn't fall off. Okay. Squish the fan all back together. Put it all back together real good. Get the shroud all back on the thing real good. And left it sit overnight. I put it back in this morning. It worked beautiful. Not even a noise. It was great. And I, as far as I know, the little piece hasn't flung off yet, so... it may let go, I don't know, and then it'll probably go if you're being out of balance, so I don't know. But I'm probably actually almost due for a new computer anyways, because the other day I preloaded Grand Theft Auto 5 onto the computer. 59 frickin' gigabyte. Oh, wowee. That game is almost $1 a gigabyte, actually. $60, 59 gigabytes, huge. So we got that preloaded, and then I was talking to my buddy Landy Kid there, and he's like, oh man, I don't know if my computer, where he's staying, is going to run this thing or not. I'm like, oh, I never even really thought of that. So he's reading the specs off to me. I'm like, I don't think that video card's going to pass. Mine, I mean. I don't think my processor's maybe just barely going to pass. I think I got enough hard drive space. And that was about all I could do for it. That's not good. So I'm kind of maybe looking for another computer anyways. Hang on a sec here. Let's look her up, because I'm sure when I got this other one, I made a video on it. I'm pretty sure I did anyways. Let's just load up the channel. New. UTR, new computer. So handy having a computer down here, let me tell you. New computer, picked up, setting up new computer for the first time use. That, no, I don't think that's it. New computer, make it 2012. Let me view this here and see if this is the one. This is a while ago, because it looked like I titled this one, this will make vlogging life eyes cry. When it used to boot, yeah. It used to boot up really fast, now it doesn't do that anymore either. Stupid thing. So anyways, we'll just, holy crap.
How's it going, tubes?
Wow. Let me watch this. This is pretty embarrassing. Ah, I found her now. That other video wasn't a real one, but I did find this one. This is the one I'm running now. That's the... Oh, crap. Yeah, that's a monitor anyways, but... So, let's see here. We're just setting up. Okay, so this was... Go down. I got a mouse sitting right beside me, but I'm holding you guys. April 13th, 2012. So, we're almost 3 years on this computer. So, probably done pretty good. I'll tell you, it's edited a lot of videos for me, and it doesn't owe me nothing there, let me tell you. So, probably should be looking for something. I want to play this GTA, but I want to play the GTA. I don't want to have to turn it like down to like minimum settings just to be able to move anywhere in it, you know. So, I don't know. I'm probably going to have to do something. Now, as you know, in Ontario and, well, I guess Canada-wide, Future Shop is no longer. What the heck? Future Shop is no longer. It's now BestBuy.ca or Best Buy Canada. The one over here is open, but they still have like no stock of nothing, so I don't know when it's going to actually come around. But the one computer I was looking at, they have down in the city, of course. I'd have to drive all the way down the city to get one, but you could order it in. I did that with this thing, with this Lenovo here. I could do that, get them to bring it in, but I'd rather just kind of go down and pick it up rather than them bouncing it around in the back of some delivery truck and, you know, stuff like that. So, yeah. But, 2012, yeah, so this would be 3 years, so that's actually not too bad for, you know, pretty much being on every day since then. It's hardly, I don't ever shut it off hardly. I'm going away or something somewhere, I'll shut it down, but, you know, for an expensive period of time, when we go away, I'll shut her down, but usually it's on all the time, because I hate waiting for stuff to boot up. Now, this thing's beautiful right now. But, actually, just while we're gabbing here, Best Buy Canada, let's just look one up here. The one, of course, that I wanted, they don't have pretty much anywhere. So let's load her up here. I don't know if you guys can see this too well, but... I got a mouse here. What am I doing? Products. Desktop computers. Now, I'm not messing around with, like, you know, this. I go 900 and up, because that's going to give you pretty much the best of the best of the best. As of the best right now. And then go prices to highest to lowest. So, I don't think I want to spend $3,000 on a computer. I can't remember what the heck one it was I was looking at now, but these are pretty darn fancy. I think it was actually this one. $1,399. Hey. So it's an HP. I've always had HP stuff and had really good luck with them. HP Envy Phoenix 810 desktop PC. Actually, let's click on this guy. This is kind of like the one I got now, except, you know, better. Of course, it's always better. Always better. Okay, so processor is an Intel Core i7-4770K. 3.5 gigahertz, 8 gigabyte. I thought it had more than that. 8 gigabyte, a PC, you know, blah, blah, blah. 2 terabyte hard drive, Super Multi, Windows, NVIDIA GeForce, GTX, 760 graphics. Maybe this wasn't the one I was looking at last night. Didn't sound right. Didn't give a whole lot of... Okay, hang on a sec here. Let's just back her up one Dewey. It looked just like that one, but I don't think it was that one. Well, actually, let's narrow it down to this i7s. Maybe it was that one. I know it was an HP. I don't know. Hang on. Let me do some digging here, see if I can find her. Okay, maybe this was the one. I really can't remember now. I think this something like the one they got just got Dylan to. They got it in Brampton, Heartland Center, and Woodbridge, which, you know, is not really close to me. But anyways, this one is a fourth generation Intel Core i7-4790. It's a little higher. Processor speed 3.60 gigahertz, four cores. Got 12 gigabyte PC3, 1280 DDR3, blah, 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 blah. Expandable to 16, if you wanted to. Hard drive capacity is a 1 terabyte serial ATA. It's not that big of a hard drive, really. Hard drive speed, optical, to Windows. So NVIDIA, never had an NVIDIA either. I've always had ATI stuff, Radeon stuff, which is now AMD stuff. So NVIDIA GeForce GTX 745 graphics with 4 gigabyte. I've only got 1 gigabyte on my card now, of DDR3 dedicated memory. Video memory, Windows 8. Stupid Windows 8. I guess I could get used to it. It's on this thing. So far, so good. Touchscreen display. Now, this one has mine. This one here. And networking inputs, outputs. Card reader. That's good. It's got a bazillion different cards that'll read. Holy frig. That's good, because that's what I use in my cameras. So. USB ports. Top IO 2 USB 3.0. Rear 4 USB 2.0. 2 USB 3.0, front 4 USB 2.0. So there's not a whole lot of 3s on it, but it's alright. There's some other crap here too, I don't know, some of that I don't even really understand, but it's only got a 300 watt power supply. Really? Wow, it's kind of small. But anyways, got a 5 out of 5 for 5 star rating, so can't see for the light, sorry. 5 star rating, so that's pretty good, so $1,000 for that one, though. I don't know why the other one's more, because it's actually crappier. Maybe it's smaller components but better components in it. I don't know. Maybe it's got different RAM chips but smaller RAM chips. Like the other one's only 8 gigabyte, and this one's hang on a sec, I'll load up both pages here. Okay, so the big dollar one is HP Envy Phoenix 810 desktop PC. Intel Core 4770K. This one's a 4790. No K though, I'm not sure what the K means. K. Whoa. The big one's got 12 gig of RAM. This one's got 12 gig of RAM. Windows 8.1, 2 terabyte hard drive though. It's got a bigger hard drive in this one, which really is fine. I don't really need a huge hard drive. Okay, let's load up. Let's load up this. Specs on this one and the specs on this one. Okay, so this one, yeah, 3.5 gigahertz processor speed. This one's 3.6, it's a little faster there. The cheaper one's faster. 2 terabyte hard drive. Now, here it says 8 gigabyte though. What the frig? Oh, 8 blah blah blah. So it's got an 8 gigabyte chip, I guess, and a 4 gigabyte chip. Okay, and this one's got 12 gigabyte all together, so it's got 1.8 gigabyte and 1 times 4, so 1 times 8 gigabyte. Wow, that's quite a way to do it. So I don't know, mostly everything so far seems to be about the same. So this more expensive one has a you can't see for the light, sorry. NVIDIA GeForce GTX 760. Where's this one here? This one's a little smaller. NVIDIA GeForce GTX 745, 760. And, of course, here doesn't tell you how much is on that card. I would assume it's 4 though. So the more expensive one's got a little bit better video card in it. But I don't know, like, it's also $300 more. $1,399 to $1,049. So $300 more gets you a little bit better video card. And the RAM's sort of set up a little different. And it's got a lower, the more expensive one's got a lower CPU that I can see anyways. I don't know. Lower gigahertz too, so. I don't know, it's a kind of a toss-up. Do you want to spend more and maybe not get much more? Or do you want to, I don't know. So, probably I'd go for this guy here, the 1049. I don't know. See, the other one is in stock, six remaining, but it's not at any of the stores. So you'd have to have it, that one delivered. Free delivery arrives by Friday, April 10th. Tomorrow? Yeah. If ordered by 4 p.m. Yeah, I bet. I doubt it. It took me like 6 days to get this one. You see right in front of you here. I highly doubt that'll be here by tomorrow. See, I could just drive to Brampton and get this instead of... I don't know, that's so stupid. Where's that Brampton store? Not that I'm going down today. Probably won't be this week for sure at all, but... Peel Center Drive, Unit 4, Brampton, Ontario. Oh, Bramley City Center. Oh, okay. That's basically just straight... What? Bramley City Center. Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, there's a big mall right here. You can't even see that, I'm sorry. There's a big mall right here. Could go down and get that one, maybe. I don't know. Still kind of up in the air about it. Well, I guess that's about her for today. I just got back from meeting people in the office over there, the her secretary and stuff. Paycheck. So, all of her paycheck. But anyways, yeah, that's I guess it for today. Run out of time. It's like... 6:07 now, holy cow, I better get going. I gotta download these files off the SD card, onto the computer, get them all situated in the program there, render them all up, and then upload it, and then process it. So hopefully it's up by 9:30 tonight, so it takes that much time. So, but anyways, I guess that's it for today. Tomorrow Landy Kid comes. I can't remember exactly what time, but I think it was maybe in the afternoonish sometime or something like that. And he's staying overnight on Friday, tomorrow Friday. And then my buddy Daz is coming up on Saturday, bright and early. He's leaving his place at like 5:30, I think he said, to get here for around 9. So it's a bit of a drive for him, which kind of sucks because, you know, it's like 2.5-3 hour drive one way. So holy cow, by the time he gets home again, that'll be like 6-7 hours of driving. So, holy crap, that really sucks when you stop and think about that. That's a lot of driving. But anyways, it'd be awesome to see him. And awesome to see you, buddy, tomorrow or Saturday when you come. And Matt and I will be here at the garage waiting. So, sometime on Saturday morning, bright and early. But anyways, that's it for today. I'm going to try my best to do some farm sim Saturday for you for Saturday. Now I don't know whether I'm going to get to too much, but the other night we did jump on Landy Kid's got his dedicated server that we were on, and there was I think 4 of us on playing doing some logging and stuff. I was on the cutting machine guy, cutting the links off, worked pretty good, but then the server started bugging out and kind of crashed and kind of weird on us, and got really laggy and stuff. So that's about, I got about half an hour of play there, but I don't know if I'm going to get to too much more for this week. Just should have done it earlier in the week, but I'm going to end up running out of time here. All the time I got is pretty much tonight, and it's probably not going to work too good because I'm going to be rendering this like most of the night and getting this ready and stuff for you. So Friday, I can't really do it Friday because Matt will be here. Landy Kid will be here, and you know, I want to spend time with him and stuff, not really on a computer. So yeah, because it takes pretty much a Farm Sim Saturday 2-hour video pretty much takes a day to render it, upload it, and process it and get it ready for Saturday. So if it's not up by like tonight, or you know, rendering tonight and upload it tomorrow, it's not going to be up for Friday or Saturday. So I might just do up what I got on the server from the other night and just plunk that out for you. And it was kind of cool, but yeah, it got kind of sort of cruddy in the end there, where it started getting all laggy and stuff. And actually, some of it I wasn't too bad for. Some of the other guys were having a heck of a time with it though. And you drive, you know, like your tractor ahead, your tractor would sit there, but your implement on the front would keep driving. It was really weird, so I don't know what was going on there. I don't know if Matt had figured it out since then, but anyways, that's his server, so if you want to ask him anything about that, just ask him on his channel. Send him a PM or on his, I think he's got a Facebook thing too. Yeah, he does. So you can ask him on there too. But anyways, that's it for me tonight. I gotta head her home, get this rocking, and get ready for Matt tomorrow and stuff. So have a good night. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you probably tomorrow. See if Matt wants to do some video stuff, maybe. We'll see what happens. If not, I don't know. We were kind of thinking about doing a live show, maybe. When exactly, I don't know. And I don't really have anything set up, so I don't know if it's even going to happen. But a live show would be kind of cool. But I don't know. I don't know yet. So be best to do it on Saturday. But I think we're going to be kind of busy tearing this thing apart here Saturday. And it's supposed to be crappy tomorrow and tonight. It's supposed to be like a wicked amount of rain, like 50 millimeters of rain and thunder and all this lovely stuff. So it's going to be pretty wet and mushy out too. So we could have almost done a nice outdoor live show while we're tearing this Jeep apart, but I kind of doubt the weather's going to permit that. Plus my little camera I've got is pretty much got to be like right on top of the thing to be able to see what's happening, right? And I don't really want to be dragging cords and all that stuff outside there and all the goo, unless I get ambitious enough and push it into the back of the shop here. I don't know. We'll see. But anyways, have a good night. Thanks for watching. And we'll catch you, I guess, when we catch you. Have a good night.